alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I haven't been talking to you for so long. There is a lot of events, most important ones that I find me a wife, a beautiful one. And I'm gonna, very soon we're gonna be inshallah together, inshallah. This is one of the most important things that happened in the last, it's been like 6 weeks or more. And, I've been talking to her for almost a couple of months, or no, more than that actually, since Ramadan, alhamdulillah. Beautiful, beautiful woman. Young, educated, very kind, and beautiful inside and outside. And I really, really love her, and looking forward to have a family. What I always wanted, and hopefully this time I'll be there. I won't be removed from the scene. But anyway, inshallah, make things easier, bless us, bless our life together. Inshallah. Okay, this is more important. Now there is another things that happened. I got another encounter with the FBI because they said that I'm posting stuff that concerned them on Facebook, and we had a meeting and a phone interview first, and then I insisted that to go and meet them. We had the meeting, and there is a lot of things that been cleared. They were very proper, professional, and courteous. Both of them, two agents came, and we just discussed things, and I explained my point of view, and I explained to them that this is getting old. It's been I've been targeted. for the last 6 years, just because some clowns went there and said Muhammad Shaban is a terrorist, because he couldn't steal money from me and my children, and I stood up and I protested. That's a terrorist. when crimes committed against you and your family. And you stand up and you protest and you said, oh wow, this is not, I'm not liking it, then you are a terrorist. And you have to be taught a lesson. Explain things, and I talked to them to look for the real terrorists and the real criminals that they are terrorizing people and beating them up and killing them in the street, shooting them in the back. And everybody knows who I'm talking about. They did it in Ferguson, they did it in with that Zimmerman, they did it everywhere, New York, everywhere in the country, in all states of the Union. So this just define who's doing what and who needs protection from whom. And I'm not trying to say anything about the law enforcement, all of them, because I have met a lot of decent, the decent Americans that they are in law enforcement are over, way over outnumber the thugs, and they don't do a job because they have an oath, but there is a lot of people that individuals that don't belong there because they're fascist and they corrupted. And they won't do us or our country any good. They just, by nature, they're a psychopath. And, you know, this is the people that we have to watch out. Watch and try to remove from, you know, the system. You know, our government and our official politicians, they should, you know, have the laws to protect the commonwealth of the country, of our nation, but in the meantime, protect the people that they are, that this law enforcement hired to protect and serve, not to abuse and kill and strip their freedom, you know, intimidate and, strip them from their civil liberties and, constitution rights and so on and so forth. You know, we are not here in China or Egypt or places where they have the worst human rights violations. And sadly to say, this country is getting there. And if we don't, you know, if we don't stand up and protest and let them know peacefully, let them know that this is not right. You know, we don't victimize our own people and you know, have them as a disposable recyclable items in the system just to brand them and you know, push them to poverty, crimes and drug addictions and everything else. So it's unacceptable. This is not America. This is unacceptable, guys. And then turn around and tell them that you are a terrorist, this and you're a terrorist, this. No, that's not gonna jive. And anyway, that's exactly what I explained to them. And you know, they were very nice. I didn't have anything to hide. Never had. You know, since the beginning of this endeavor, the other side committed a lot of crimes and fraud the system, fraud the state, fraud the county, and the social security, the feds, and, you know, evaded from paying taxes and violated labor laws and commit every crime and pay his way through or what have you, or you know, I would say corrupted politicians and judges and clowns to help him or them to do that. I don't want to really single anybody out, but you know, we didn't do anything. We just work hard and being very sincere, and we're trying to do the right thing. And as a result, you know, we've been, you know, it's not right. It's not right. But anyway, one more thing I want to mention about, you know, the community centers and churches and mosques and, you know, the people that are supposed to be helping, please, you know, just, you know, try to rethink what you're doing and work for, try to, you know, help the poor, help the needy, help the people that they are on the bottom of the food chain. There are a lot of them there, it's homeless children, families, elderly, people with addictions. I mean, they didn't, you know, it's things that they inherit from our society and the way of life and culture and everything. So we have to start, you know, redeploying our effort and try to give them a hand. And this is why, you know, again, this is why we've been created. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And ibadah is to love one another. This is part of it. بعض. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى لو يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. And also the unity. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. All of this, it's our principles, it's our Quran, it's the teaching of Islam, and we can't just be sitting with the sultan and clapping our hand and say good job and help them to do the injustice to everybody, to let them. It's haram, it's not acceptable, and there is no excuse for that. أقول قولي هذا، أستغفر الله لي ولكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.